Hi, in this video we'll prepare a scene in 3D Max for Unreal. The first thing to do is to split the objects to make it easier to create UVs in Unreal. Convert to editable poly, in this case a wall. Select the inner polygon and make detach. Next, I will use hotkeys. I'll show you how this is done and how much it speeds up the process. Now I convert this wall surface to editable poly in the same way. I take polygons, there will be three of them. As you can see, this surface is internal, and so I can press detach in the same way, or I can use the hotkey. Here, look, I press the hotkey and press OK. See, the inner part is already divided. And we hide it in the same way with the hotkey. This box, which is a light protector on top, it will not allow excess light to pass through, and the ceiling itself can also be left as it is. It is already sufficiently divided, so we also hide this ceiling. Here we have such a large volume in terms of the number of objects in the chandelier, and such a many objects must be combined into one. In this case we make ungroup, that is go to group, make ungroup, and now be sure to save, because a crash may occur before the objects are merged. Trying to merge all to make 3ds Max crashes for me, because either you need to make sure that there are no extra objects other than geometry. This is firstly. And secondly, if there are a lot of objects, then use the merge all script, which I will attach, and you can use it. In addition, you also need to select a group of objects and not all objects at once. For example, here the plugin swears that the selected lights will not be grouped either. Select only the light selection, Ctrl plus A and hit delete. Do not forget that we put on the selection of all objects and now merge all, also in parts. Let me try to combine everything now, it will take some time. Everything turned out well, it literally took a little time, and now we hide our chandelier and continue to prepare our objects. Now I will put the normal display. Here I will select standard. Here is such a wall, it also needs to be divided. We repeat the procedure. Editable poly, take polygons, select this part of the wall and simply split it. Separate it from this panel and hide it with hotkeys. These panels can also be used. I hide them for now, I don't need to separate them. Convert the next wall to editable poly. The inner surface detach. OK, and immediately hide it. In principle, this must always be repeated. This is such a simplified method, it must be done practically always. In the workflow, it is slightly different, there it is more meticulous. I hit the picture, let's work with the sofa now. Let's make an ungroup and see, the sofa itself is divided into objects. Into pillows and the sofa itself, into separate objects already detached. So we just choose it and create a group. Sign it so that you will understand. We'll use a plugin that will transfer all this and it will transfer the groups as well. We hide the sofa. Moving on to the coffee table. Here it is quite normal, it is already divided. But if it is not divided, then you can see how desirable it needs to be divided, that is, each element is separate. So, I highlight and hide, but first these small rubber bands that are located at the bottom, it is also desirable to select and group them. This will help you later select objects faster in Unreal. We also do everything. Press X, then merge all. What merge all does in general? It does the same familiar to attach, but only all selected objects at once. That is, you don't need to endlessly click on objects. You can simply select them and by selecting merge all, combine all objects, preserving sub-objects, collapse. A standard tool, it doesn't do this. It erases all materials. Convert to editable poly, attach, or simply select the object. Check that it is only selected and hide it. The tray is normally divided, hide it. Now it's the same with the table. I just leave the objects up and without fixing the offset, I right-click, thus cancelling the action. Convert the floor, select the top cover, detach, OK and hide. You can hide here too. We still have such elements. And we didn't hide them, we are also just hiding them now. The light can be removed, you can leave it, no difference. For Unreal we'll say, do not transfer the light. And in any case we will create all the lights once in Unreal. We check that we also have doors. The door is disconnected. See the lock on the panel? And in general, all the elements were separate to make it easier to bake the light. But, for example, let me demonstrate if we have a solid door and we need to separate it. It is clear how to combine, but how to separate the model? How to divide it into elements? We do merge all, assign an edit mesh on top or convert to editable mesh and take in the elements. Select all the elements of our model with Ctrl plus A or just using the selection frame. Going down, we need to find explode opposite it. Add 180, explode, OK. Our elements are now decoupled into separate objects. We carry out the usual procedure. Select and check our objects. If the inner part of the walls is already separated, then we simply hide it. The same thing, we double check our door. We hide it. You can use the right mouse button or hide selection or, as I advised, use hotkeys. But this is not necessary. As you are used to, work like that. The objects that we have left, we also select one object at a time. Check if everything is fine. Here you can, for example, select the window completely. It is disconnected into an impost and into a frame, into glass, and we hide it. We do the same with the chair. We check if it is grouped. If it is grouped, we must ungroup it. We make it so that the selected object does not belong to a group, and only after that we do merge all. Or explode, if necessary. I checked and put it back in the group. This chair has already been divided into sub-objects, so we don't need to divide or combine, everything is fine here. The only thing is it possible to divide the back and armrest into two more elements? Perhaps the back and the front can be separated. Select the elements, make an explode 180 degrees. Great! We managed to separate the inner and outer parts of the shell. We do the same with the seat. We separate the upper part and the lower part. Thus simplifying the process of baking the light. This will simplify and improve unwrapping in Unreal. After that, simply select our object and create a group. The base can no longer be divided here. This is already understandable. It could be divided, but it's not such a large object and it will normally be deployed. Once again, we check that the chair is in the same group and hide. Now the lamp. In principle, we'll hide it in the same way, because it will also be metallic and the baked light will not be visible on it. I will check here. It is very important. Check and assign edit mesh. Take and select polygons and see that these normal guides are directed. This concerns any objects, so that these antenna guides are blue, so that they look face forward. And if this is not the case, then you need to select polygons or elements and do flip. I am oversimplifying the amount of geometry on the curtain. It is too huge for the sweeps to be created correctly. It is possible in a checkboard pattern. It is possible through one, by choosing rolls to select polygons and make a detach. After that, having already selected each detached object, apply explode. For example, for this object, the same thing. Select the element and do detach. Or assign edit mesh. Select all elements, 180 degrees. Explode. That's it. We have all the elements separated. This is a separate object, which will be assigned a separate sweep for baking the light. These are the pigtails left here, but these objects will also unfold normally, and everything will be fine. We do unhide all, select only the geometry, you can press Ctrl plus A. We do reset X form, I press it several times, converting to editable poly so that we have no geometry distortions or scale. And everything is correctly transferred to Unreal.